हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द ट्रिक टू सॉल्व इक्विवेलेंट इंपेडेंस सम्स। लेट मी टेल यू, दिस इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू सी द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस, कैपेसिटेंस एंड इंडक्टेंस। ओके, सो फर्स्ट लेट अस सी द थिंग्स दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर टुडे। वी आर गोइंग टू सी द टू बेस्ट सम्स दैट आर सिलेक्टेड बाय मोस्ट ऑफ द टेस्ट सीरीज एंड मोस्ट लाइकली टू बी सिलेक्टेड फॉर गेट क्वेश्चन। देन वी आर गोइंग टू सी टू टू थ्री गेट क्वेश्चंस। Then at the end, we are going to see the infinite ladder impedance, okay? This is most important one. So watch this video till the end. So let's start with the first sum and there only we will see the trick. So the first sum is that the equivalent capacitance of the arrangement shown below about PQ is assume all the capacitor value as C, okay? And this circuit is given below. We have to find the equivalent capacitance across this P and Q. So first take a look how I solve this sum and then I will show you the trick. Equivalent capacitance is 3C. Okay, interesting, right? So let's see this trick into detail. So the first thing that you should know is that whenever you come across capacitance in parallel, okay, and the value is written something like this, let's say 1 farad, 2 farad, 3 farad, okay, if the capacitance value is written in farad, it is not in reactance, then you have to add the capacitance, okay? So the total capacitance will be 3 2 5 plus 1 is 6 farad is will be the equivalent capacitance, okay? And if you come across capacitance in series, okay, so let's say if the capacitance is somewhat like this, okay, let's say 1 farad 2 farad, okay, then we are going to add them parallelly. So what I'm saying is that now the capacitance equivalent will be 1 upon 1 plus 1 upon 2 and inverse. Basically, whatever the formula that you use for resistance in parallel, that we are going to use for capacitance equivalent when it is in series, okay? So the answer will be 2 plus 1 3 by 2 and inverse will be 2 by 3 farad, okay? This was for capacitance. Let's see for inductance also. Let's say if you have a inductance in parallel, let's say this is 2 Henry, this is 2 Henry. This inductance will follow the same formula as of resistance, okay? So whatever the formula that you used when resistance in parallel, that you have to use for inductance in parallel also, okay? So your 1 upon L equivalent will be this 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 2, okay? So you will get 1, so L equivalent will be 1 ka inverse, that is 1 itself, okay? And similarly, if you get the inductance in series, then you have to just add it. Let's say you have 2 Henry, 3 Henry, okay? So the L equivalent will be 5 Henry, okay? So this was the basic thing that you should know, okay? Now coming to the trick that we are going to use it, we are going to follow the same trick that we have used for the resistance. That is, first we have to check for wind bridge. Then we have to check for any equidistant point. Then we have to go for star delta, okay? Apart from this, then you have to follow this trick, okay? So the things will be more simpler to solve. So let's see this trick into the action. So coming back to the first sum, you can see the circuit was like this and we have to find the capacitance equivalent across P and Q, okay? So the first thing, you have to check for any wind bridge. You can see there is no wind bridge clearly. Then you have to go for equidistant point, okay? So first what I have done is I have marked all the points, okay? So you can see I have marked A, B, C, D, to the points where more than one capacitance are touched, okay? So after that, you have to calculate its distance from starting as well as from destination point, okay? If the distance is same, then you are going to say that these points are equidistant point, okay? So let's say if you check for A and B, so you can see P to A is one capacitance. Similarly for P to B, you will get one capacitance, okay? And if you check from the destination, you can see Q to B is one capacitance and Q to A is one capacitance, okay? So you are going to say that A and B are equidistant points. Similarly, if you check for B and C, you will get both are equidistant points. Similarly, if you check for C and D, you will say that both are equidistant point, okay? So you can say A, B, C, D all are equidistant point to each other, and the capacitance between this equidistant point will now be redundant and will be replaced by short circuit, okay? So you can see A, D, B, C are equidistant points, so the capacitance between them will now be changed to short circuited, okay? So the only capacitance we will be remaining with from P to this equidistant point and from Q to this equidistant point, okay? So if you resolve it, you can see this is my P and this is my Q, okay? The first capacitance which is between P and Q that I have drawn here, okay? And you can see from P to A we have one capacitance, from P to B we have one capacitance, from P to D we have one capacitance, from P to C we have one capacitance, okay? And we know A, B, C, D are equidistant point, so we are going to make one point for all these four points, okay? So that's what I have done here. I have made one point and connected four capacitance one by one, from P to A, from P to B, from P to C, from P to D, which is nothing but from P to this point we have four capacitance in parallel, okay? Similarly, if you see from Q, you can see from Q to A we have one capacitance, from Q to B we have one capacitance, from Q to C we have one capacitance, and from Q to D we have one capacitance, okay? So similar to this, I have drawn from Q also, and we get four capacitance in parallel, and the other point of this capacitance is nothing but this same point, okay? So whenever we come across the capacitance in parallel, we have to add simply. So here we will get 4C, again here we will get 4C, right? And we can say this 4C and this 4C is in series, right? So now we have to use the parallel wala formula. We know 4C parallel 4C will be 2C directly. I have explained you already, if you get two resistance in parallel with the same value, then the equivalent resistance will be R by 2. If you get three resistance in parallel, then the equivalent resistance will be R by 3, that thing, okay? So from the concept of this, you can see 4C parallel 4C will be 2C, okay? So here we have C, 2C, and we have to find the capacitance equivalent across these two points. So you can see this capacitance are in parallel, so you have to simply add it, you will get the capacitance equivalent as 3C, right? Now let's see this sum, and the sum is find equivalent impedance seen by the voltage source, okay? So we have to find the Z equivalent from this voltage source, and you can see here in the circuit we have combination of resistance, capacitance and inductance, okay? And we have already told that we have to assume omega equals to 1 radian, okay? So whenever you come across this type of question where you have both inductance, capacitance and resistance, then the best way to solve this is you have to convert it into its reactance, okay? Basically you have to convert into J form, okay? So you can see we have 1 Henry inductor, we have 1 farad capacitance, and we have 1 ohm resistance, okay? For converting inductance into reactance, we know, right, L we can write as SL. S is nothing but J omega L, right? Omega we know it is 1 radian, so we can write it as J into L. L we know it is 1 Henry, okay? So it will be J simply. So 1 Henry will be converted to J. Similarly, this 1 farad will be converted into C to 1 upon SC, okay? S we know J omega. Omega is 1, so it will be simply minus J, right? That denominator J will come to numerator and the sign will be changed, okay? C value is 1 itself. 1 ohm will be simply as it is. So now if we try to simplify the circuit, we have to always start from the end. You can see we have 1 Henry and 1 ohm resistance at this branch, okay? So for that, the equivalent impedance will be 1 plus J, right? 1 plus J. For inductance, we are going to use J, right? And note one thing, when you have converted all capacitance, inductance and resistance into its reactance form, then it will follow simply resistance. There you don't need to follow the different formula for capacitance, different formula for inductance. Okay, at that time all will follow the formula of resistance as you have converted into reactance. Okay, so basically what I'm saying is, if you come across two inductance in parallel, then you have to simply use the formula of resistance itself. Let's say 1J and J, then you have to follow the formula of resistance, that is J parallel J. And if you come across capacitance in parallel that you have converted into reactance, let's say this is minus J and minus J, then you have to use the formula of resistance itself. Okay, so now you are not going to simply add, you are going to use the formula of resistance only, that is minus J parallel with minus J. So what I'm saying is, if you have converted into reactance, then you have to simply follow the formula of resistance. Okay, if you have not converted into reactance, then you have to follow that starting concept that I have given to you. Okay, so now let's simplify branches one by one. So we have simplified this branch. Now let's see, for this here we have an inductance parallel with capacitance. So you can see this is J, this is minus J. When we come across this thing, we have to simply follow the resistance formula, that is J parallel with minus J. Okay, so we will get J into minus J upon J plus minus J. It will be J minus J itself. Okay, so you can see we have minus J square, it is nothing but plus 1 upon 0, right? So it is nothing but infinite. So you can see the impedance of this branch is nothing but infinite, which means that this branch is simply open circuited. Okay, so all these similar branches are simply open circuited. Okay, now let's see, for this branch you can see we have a capacitance in series with inductance. Okay, so you can see this is minus J and J. So we are going to use the formula of resistance itself. So in series we are going to simply add, so we will get J minus J, which is nothing but 0 ohm. So at this time, when you have impedance as 0 ohm, then you are going to short circuit, right? When you have infinite, you will open circuit. When you have 0, you are going to short circuit. Okay, so we can say all these branches are going to short circuited. Okay, and the only difference will be this branch, and this branch we have already calculated from this. This is nothing but 1 plus J. So we will be remaining only with this and this, and this will be open circuit, this will be short circuited. Okay, so what I'm saying is, we will have here 1 plus J, this will be short circuit, this will be short circuit, and we have this branch. So we will be only remaining with this 1 plus J, and we have to find the Z equivalent across this. Okay, so this is in series, so we will simply add it. It will be 2 plus 2J. Okay, so this is the answer. So this is the Z equivalent seen by this voltage source. Okay, so you can see this sums becomes easier if you know the basic concepts and the trick that I have given to you. Okay, so now let's say some gate sum. So the third sum is, in the circuit of figure, the equivalent impedance seen across terminal AB. Okay, this is A, this is B, and we have to find the impedance seen by these two points. Okay, so as the trick says, first we have to check for wind bridge. So you can see it has a wind bridge, so we have to check whether it is satisfying its condition or not. So you can see 2 by 2 is nothing but 1, 4 by 4 is nothing but 1. Okay, so we are going to say that the current flowing to this branch is 0 ampere, so we are going to simply open circuit. Okay, you can also short circuit, you will get the same answer. Okay, so we can say we have a modified circuit like this, A, B, 2 series with 2, it is nothing but 4 ohm, 4 series with 4 ohm, we will get 8 ohm. Okay, so if we find out the Z equivalent across this, we will get 4 into 8 upon 4 plus 8. It is nothing but 8 4 is 32 upon 12. Okay, so the answer will be 4 8s are 4 3s are. So the B option will be correct one. Now let's see this sum. This is from WE99. The equivalent capacitance measured between B and Y will be. So you are given with this circuit, and we have to find out the capacitance equivalent across this B and Y. Okay, so you can see this is a simple circuit. This R and this point is directly short circuited, so we can modify this circuit as like this. This is your B, this is your capacitance, this is Y, and this point is connected with C. We know this point and this point are same. As you can see, we have a short circuit here, so we will say this CS is now parallel with CC, right? And we have this path, and again we have this CS here, and this CS will be parallel with this CC. Right, and we have CC here. Now you can see we don't have capacitance in reactance form. We have capacitance in farad form, okay? So we are going to simply use the trick that I have told you in starting, okay? So you can see we have capacitance in parallel, so we are going to simply add it. So here we will get CC plus CS, okay? And here also we will get same thing, that is CC plus CS. Now the modified circuit become like this. This is CC and here we have a CC plus CS. Again we have CC plus CS and this is the second end, okay? This is P and this is Y. Now you can see these two capacitance are in series, so we have to use the parallel formula. So you can see these two capacitance are of the same value, so it will be nothing but CC plus CS by 2. This will be equivalent capacitance of these two capacitance in series, right? And you can see this capacitance is in parallel with this CC, so we are going to simply add it. We will get plus CC, so this is our capacitance equivalent. So if you simplify it, we will get CC by 2 plus CC, it is nothing but 3CC by 2 plus CS by 2. So from the option you can see this C is the correct answer, right? Now let's see this interesting question. This is from EE18 and we have to find the equivalent impedance Z equivalent for infinite ladder circuit, okay? So you can see we have a infinite ladder circuit and we have to find Z equivalent across this point, okay? This type of sum we have missed in equivalent resistance, but the way that we solve for impedance, it will be similar to resistance also, okay? So you can see this branch and this branch is repeating in this ladder network, okay? So what we have to do is we will write the first branch as it is j9 ohm. This will be j5 ohm and this is minus j1 ohm, and we are going to write here Z equivalent, right? Why we are going to write Z equivalent here? Because this is an infinite ladder. You can consider it as an C and you are removing one drop from that C, so the quantity of that water will remain same, okay? So you have to consider like this. So we have removed this branches and we have seen Z equivalent from this. So you can see this is nothing but the same ladder network, okay? So now we have to simply solve this equivalent circuit. So we will get J 9 ohm plus this branches is parallel to each other, okay? Now you can see this is in J, okay? So you have to follow the resistance formula only. So you can see J5 minus J1 ohm will be J4 ohm, right? So J4 ohm is in parallel with Z equivalent, okay? So we'll write it as like this, J4 multiplied by Z equivalent plus J4 plus Z equivalent. Now if we try to simplify this equation, we will simply multiply this J4 plus Z equivalent across this equation. So we'll get J4 into Z equivalent plus Z equivalent into Z equivalent is nothing but Z equivalent square is equals to J9 into J4, it is nothing but minus 36, right? Plus J9 into Z equivalent, right? Plus J4 into Z equivalent, right? So you can see this J4 Z equivalent and J4 Z equivalent will get cancelled and you will be remaining only with Z equivalent ka square minus J9 into Z equivalent plus 36 equals to 0. So now you have a quadratic equation and you will always find that we can't find the root directly, so we have to use the formula that minus b plus minus under root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a, okay? So you can see a is 1, b is minus J9 and c is 36, okay? So if we put all these values into this formula, we will get minus b will be nothing but J9, minus minus gets converted to plus, b square will be minus J9 ka square, okay, minus 4ac, a is 1, c is 36, okay, upon 2a, 2 into 1, okay? So we have J9 plus minus J9 ka square, okay? So it is nothing but minus ka square will be plus, J ka square will be in minus, okay? And 9 ka square will be 81, okay? So it will be minus 81 minus 4 into 36 is nothing but 72 into 2, it is 144, right? So we'll get 144 minus 81 and upon 2, okay? So you will see This minus 81 minus 144, it is nothing but 225. Okay, so here we will get J9 plus minus 225 is a square of 15, right? So we will get 15J here. Why J? Because you can see we have a negative in a root. Okay, so you have to know this thing that under root of minus 1 is simply J. Okay, so here what you have done is you have taken negative sign common and you have simply added 81 plus 144, and you know this under root of minus 1 will be J, and this under root of 81 plus 144 you have taken. Okay, so you will get 15J upon it will be 2. Okay, so if you add and subtract it, you will get J9 plus J15, it will be J24. J24 by 2, it will be J12. And if you subtract it, you will get J9 minus J15, it is nothing but minus J6 by 2, it will be minus J3. Okay, so you can see we have two different impedance value, and from the option you can see J12 is the correct one. Okay, so we are going to tick this. Okay, note one thing, minus J3 is possible, but if we have a resistance in minus, then we have to neglect this value. Okay, but in the impedance we have to consider both of these values. Okay, whereas if you get two values for infinite ladder resistance sum, you have to neglect negative one and you have to select the positive one. Okay, here in this case J12 was matching with the options, that why I have ticked the J12. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you guys.